everybody, it's me, Lord Scrambles Dick. Anyways, in the last episode, we had been placed in a fairly awkward situation because most of our A-team was benched, and we unfortunately were strapped with a mission. However, I have decided that I will not be skipping this, that I will be doing this, and that everything will be fine. Now, I have a couple choices.
And by a couple, I mean two. Option A, I do this one for the intel. Or option B, I do this one to stop the arguably worst dark event. That being said, I could probably be okay with, like, letting this one slide for a while. Oh, it's a tough call. You have to fight a Gatekeeper, a Codec, an Archon, but no Andromeda. Super Heavy Mech, Gatekeeper, Andromeda. That intel could be really important. We are going to go here.
Setting course for West Africa.
To get that intel. Cause honestly, the Viper rounds one isn't even that big of a deal. As long as, like, disaster doesn't strike. And I gotta make utility items available because we're obviously running with a non-standard crew. We got you heavy ordnance. So we are going to... We're gonna give you the war suit. Yeah, nice. And we are going to... make weapons available. Wait a second, does that... Hang on. I'm interested. Okay, so I selected make weapons available. So can I now choose... Oh god damn it! That's not what I meant to do. That is good to know that I can do that, because it means that I can, like... Okay. Get rid of your beam cannon, which only has... just a stock on it. Take this bad boy. And we're gonna give you... the blaster launcher. Yeah. And I don't want to put a war suit on this guy, because I want him to be able to use, that fucking sweet, psi rounds. But I should give the other war suit to someone. Oh, okay. I'm actually gonna save you guys, like, having to watch me edit all this stuff. I'm just gonna cut here and bring it back once I've got everyone equipped properly. Alright, we're back. Everyone has been tricked out to the extent that I think is necessary. Everything looks good, so let's go ahead and get started on this mission. Right? Everything looks good, right? Yeah. Got my two war suit heavies. You don't actually even need to put your, like, warsuits on heavies. I just do because, like, when you give them to grenadiers with volatile mix, then you're only seeing, like, a 33% loss in utility effectiveness, whereas with anybody else it would be a 50% loss.
Recent intel suggests the data the Resistance found is critical to the aliens' latest operation. Unfortunately, Advent is already moving to take out the device. We can't let that happen. Eliminate all hostile contacts and secure the area. Protect that device at all costs.
In the early game, I don't think these missions are that bad, but in the later game, they become more of a nuisance. I'd rather have, like, a hard time limit mission.
Hostile forces are already moving to destroy the data tap installed nearby. We need to lock down the area and secure the device at all costs.
Huh. There were Overwatch markers on my guys for some reason.
Orders confirmed.
Let Brad move up first. See if there's anything down there. I see an Andromeda. And a Muton. Bountiful targets to mind control. If I let loose on them, can I kill them this turn is the question. And honestly, which one do I prefer? Would I rather take the Andromeda, which has less health but is a more formidable unit, or would I rather take the Muton Elite? I think I'd actually rather take the Muton Elite. And do I want to do Hail of Bullets? Or Chain Shot, actually. Not Hail of Bullets. No, we'll do the normal shot. Alright, hopefully this will get them to move somewhere where we'll be in a more favorable position. Alright, let's see where he goes. And the Muton is going to just go right on there. Okay. So now we will have a better idea of where we want to put Jagger. Oh my god.
On the move.
Oh my god. I forgot to get the Psy Amp upgrade. Okay, that's fine. This is gonna hit. I know it will. This is fine. Okay. Okay. See, everything's fine. Oh my god. No! Man, this just keeps on happening. But it's okay. I have a solution. And my solution is fucking radical, is what it is. 7 to 10? Yeah, this'll work. Yeah, Brad's gonna give him a surprise. Yo! That happened out of order. All right, let's see. How are we gonna do this? Do we even want to bother with the goddamn Archon this turn?
Rolling.
We'll We'll save him for now just because he has the item. We'll put Melissa here. Melissa could either shoot the grenade or... Yeah, that ain't gonna work.
Throwing grenade.
We'll hit him with a grenade. Yeah, I know. Battle frenzy.
I'm on it.
Let's go ahead and take a look and see what we can, like, get out of this. This hacking stat won't be great. It won't be... Ooh. Me likey. Sure, why not? It's a gimme. Heck yeah. Piercy now has super high crazy crit chance. Oh, I should have saved that. Now I can't even do an action. Alright, let's throw out that mimic beacon. Alright, let's see what happens. Ooh! Ooh, that is a lot of damage. But it's okay, because we're already, like, whittling down the enemy's numbers pretty significantly. Though we have had to expend quite a lot in terms of resources. Yeah, you're proud of yourself, I bet. Oh god, don't launch an acid bomb. Okay, good, he's just gonna melee. Their melee hits really hurt. Alright. So, he can melee for like 6. He could also throw a grenade, which would deal 4 to 5. Not particularly valuable when you consider the fact that it won't be enough to kill anything. And his gun would deal 8 to 10, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, potentially lethal, not lethal. I think the best course of action is to shoot this guy with the gun. There we go, and that knocked him into his death state. Alright. Excuse me. So Piercy now has a crazy high hack chance from a... whole thing last turn. Well, not crazy high, I guess, but, you know, high. We gotta get over there relatively quickly. I believe we've brought the enemy numbers down. This will be 5 enemies that we've killed if we, you know, kill them this turn.
On your order.
So I'll move my guy up here. Chance to hit the Archon is 100. If I chain shot him, goes down to 70, or I could kill the Andromeda. Yeah, I'll just kill the Andromeda. Bang. And death.
Hostile target down.
Okay. Start moving people up. We'll get some, let's get some people who need upgrades kills. Have Melissa move up. And start taking shots at this Archon. Someone will get a kill on this guy, that's for sure.
Weak hit.
Nah, it was fine. We'll save Pitbull just in case the absolute worst case scenario happens and we actually need an explosive to kill this guy. Appears to take a shot. 8 damage. Radical. And now...
Absolutely.
A Varyl shoot. 79. Dead.
That's how it's done. Let's do this.
And we'll have everyone move up. And well, not actually. We're not actually gonna have everyone move up. We're gonna have everyone go on Overwatch. Bam. Are they gonna walk this way? No, they're just gonna keep taking shots. Wow, that is so much damage. Alright. Anything over here? Okay, Varel, go ghost.
Hidden away. Location confirmed. I'm on it. Heading out.
Not knowing where the enemy is really, really sucks. We can't even hack the objective. We just have to, like, fucking protect it. Alright, have... I can't risk walking into the enemy. It would be fucking terrible if it happened. Ugh. They're not gonna move! They're just gonna keep fucking shooting it!
They got friends!
Why? Why is this happening? It's forcing me to make a really terrible, bad decision. I hate when the game forces me to make bad decisions. Fucking Christ, finally.
Move to protect that gear at all costs.
God damn, I hate when the pods act like this. Oh, come on! Oh, come on! Ugh. Fuck! Who has the blast- not the blaster launcher, the fucking other thing. Diesel has it, fucking. God, this fucking game. Awesome. That's literally exactly what I expected. And our muton can hit them both. All right. Grenade him. Oh, I didn't even notice that fucking Overwatch. Oh, God. Does Varel have, like... Yeah, Shadow Step. We need somebody to be able to launch a grenade in there. I don't think he can get far enough. Like, he would need to move... Jagger might actually be able to potentially fuck him up with no lance. Void rift even.
On the move.
Too far for no lance. But void rift will hit.
Enter the rift.
So we'll rift him. Hooray.
Heading out.
Confirmed.
And I'll have these guys get ready to fucking bum trap these guys as they drop in. Now let's see what happens. Cause that fucking robot's still alive. Gonna have more injuries after this one, I imagine. But thankfully, or at least hopefully, we'll have some time to recuperate. Yeah, fuck you. One damage. Great miss. Alright, we got him, but it's a graze. Oh, come on, he was hollow point targeted. There we go. Jesus.
So we got one.
Alright, let's see what that other robot does. Alright, what's he gonna do? Good! Wow! Wow! Wow, that damage! Okay, Brad can grenade these two, destroying his cover and getting rid of his Overwatch. And that is exactly what he will do. Get fucking wrecked. Zach could actually attempt a skull mine, but I'm not going to have him, because fuck that. It's not even worth it at this point. 99% chance to pretty much... to kill the Mac. Fuck it, kill it. I want Piercy here.
Your order.
We'll have him shoot this fucking stun guy. Yeah, crit boost.
Target neutralized. Weapons burning ammo fast.
Let's move already.
Now she can't get a shot off, but what she can do is she can hit him with a grenade and blow up this wall. Come on, I want to line it up right.
This is for you.
There we go. And that muton can shoot him twice. Hooray for crits. Yeah, I see that robot. Do we have any heavies left that can, like, get rid of some of its armor? We don't, but we can null lance it. Or we can mimic beacon it. Alright, let's start taking shots on them. Nothing else we can do but hope that they hit. Alright, there's some damage. And... Alright, bad coin flips.
Not a problem.
Get you right in there. Get you right on in there. And have you fucking crit. Damn it, that's not a crit!
It hit the plate!
Oh, we still have stasis. Yeah, we're gonna stasis the robot.
Under my protection.
Cause it's the safest option. I know it might seem overly cautious, but I think that's the way we gotta do it. Have these guys move up and see what he does. Oh, for fuck's sake! I can't catch a break. Well, fuck that loot. Just to make that clear right off the bat, I do not care about that loot. I will sacrifice that loot for the greater good. That Archon is straight up out of range unless I move up. Which means, like, letting the gatekeeper fucking do his thing.
Here I come.
I could put Varel there, but then he would get hit by the fucking blast. Where is the blaster lady? Yeah, I'm gonna have to sacrifice that loot for the greater good.
Headed out.
Hopefully I won't have to sacrifice any soldiers for the greater good. Please just crit. Thank you.
That's right. Burning through ammo fast.
Whoa. That was weird. Now the game won't show me whether or not this is even gonna hit. Hope it hits. There we go. Gotta save Jagger, he's got the mimic beacon. Wow, that chance to hit is high. Or chance to hit is low. I said the exact opposite of what I wanted to say.
Moving to position.
I really wish I didn't use stasis. Because now my options are pretty limited. I could move him up, there's no cover, and it would basically just be me like, wow, that's an interesting, The worst thing about, like, moving him up to null lands is that, number one, it's not going to be necessarily lethal, and number two, Alright, well, let's... Before I throw out the Mimic Beacon, I can inspire someone. No, not Soulfire. Let's inspire this guy.
We will overcome.
And now that we've inspired him... we can actually... That used both actions? No. Oh, fuck. I thought that only used one action. And he didn't even pick up the object. Oh, god damn it. Alright, suppress him. This is so fucked. I totally screwed up. I meant to throw a mimic beacon, but I can't now. Because I fucking used Inspire when I thought it only cost one action. Oh my. Well, Victor is dead.
The aliens have found a way to mind control them now.
I don't even know who that guy was. Oh, come on, not now!
This is not good.
Live. He's still alive, hurrah! Who is Victor? Which one is Victor? Who did he kill? Dead. Fucking rip in peace. I sincerely... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Who the fuck is Victor? Oh, he killed a fucking Civ. Neato, I guess. Damn it, Stasis on fucking cooldown for one more turn! And the game is being cruel and not letting me no-lands both of them. Damn it! I don't want to afflict insanity. Why didn't I bring the new Psyamp? Why wasn't I paying attention? And Pitbull's way over there! Oh, this is so... Oh my god! Okay, this is fine. This is fine. I'm not worried at all.
Moving to position.
It's fine. Damn it! Why won't it let me hit both? Okay, let's focus not on what we can't do. Let's focus on what we can do. Because I am a man of cans. Hit those fuckers with grenade. Hooray! It would be quite hilarious if he just walked up to Varro, gave him one good slap, and then Varro died. And that actually could happen.
On your order.
Alright, if this crits, we kill everything except the gatekeeper. And that is enough. Oh, hell yes!
Multiple hostiles eliminated.
Unfortunately, we don't have stasis. Okay, where's Piercy? Good old Piercy.
Heading out.
Piercy's gonna run over here. And he will heal Varro.
Gremlin, get on the heels.
Yes, yes. Meow, meow. And then Varel will run up here like a badass. And he can see through the ceiling for whatever, somehow, who knows why.
Here I come.
You'll go here and not be able to see anyone. Great. And then you'll maybe crit him and do a lot of damage. Nice. 11 damage. Not bad.
That armor's tough. Negative. Weapons try.
He's got a free action, but his weapon's empty. Darn it. Oh, that's the worst. I guess he can throw a grenade at him. No, he can't. Can you throw a grenade at this guy and knock him off, like, onto the ground where he'll, like, die of fall damage? That'd be pretty great. There we go. Die of fall damage now. There you go. Mimic Beacon, away! Don't know if that'll actually do anything, but fuck it, why not? We'll have Brad go here. And we'll have me go here. Spread everyone out so that the odds of him fucking us with his, like, AoE is, like, low. Alright, cool. Oof! 11 damage. You know what? This mission hasn't gone well, but it could have gone a hell of a lot worse. Alright, so we are going to use one action to reload. And then, we are not going to rupture, we are going to use hail of bullets. That'll reduce his armor significantly.
Hard target. Minimal damage.
And now, oh, by the way, these guys explode, so don't stand right next to them. Stand like this range away from. Oh, he needed to reload. Fuck. Well, Varel's not getting the kill.
Let's do this.
Diesel, you can try for the kill. Not enough, but anything will kill it now. Let's have good old Zachariah Pierce to go for it. Do it up.
X-ray neutralized.
Hooray!
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Yeah, fucking 11 enemies, my ass. I mean, a lot of those were resurrections, but still. So when that, like, when I saw that soldier died thing, I thought for sure, like, we'd lost Brad. So I'm quite happy that that was not the case. Apparently it was just a civilian, and, like, the game will tell you that, you know, a civilian died when they get resurrected. So that makes sense. But yeah, Operation Shadow Wagon was a go, and we got some intel, too. Our Muton Elite was a brave hero. He took a lot of hits for the greater good. And we got another Gatekeeper Shell. I don't know if you actually can do anything with them other than make the advanced Psy Amp, which I fucking forgot to make. If I didn't successfully dominate that Muton that turn, I would have at the very least lost the mission. No questions asked. I might have lost some people too. That's a maybe, but I definitely would have lost the mission. And that would have been lame. Because we've lost, like, pretty much every intel, like, optional intel mission up to this point. Which is stupid. But yeah, the B team's getting some promotions.
Squad made it back whole, and the aliens paid the price.
Or not.
Commander.
Or fucking not. God damn it. No promotions. What a bust. Bunch of shit we can sell. Next time we hit up the black market in like 9 days. Already have this shit unlocked.
You and your crew have dealt another serious blow to the aliens' efforts today, Commander.
Mm-hmm.
Impressive work.
Okay. Before I fucking forget, let's go ahead and buy the alien psi-amp. There we go. There we go. Fuck me, right? Ugh. Fucking idiot, man. Okay. Now maybe the game will let me do stuff. I don't care. Okay, we did remember to put somebody in the Advanced War Center. So our guys will be back up in no time. Everyone except Vera will be up in time for the next, like, mission. And that's all I care about.
Setting course for West Asia.
God, I couldn't believe that. 6 hours passed between me, like, in-game hours. Which is, like, 1 second of scanning. Ugh. Fucking sup, homies. You would not believe the day I have had.
We've established contact with the local resistance forces in this region,
Commander. Yep.
We're ready to move on the coordinates we pulled from the Codex.
Ugh. Now, the big question is... Oh, wait. We'll worry about that in a second.
Just like the one we found the commander in.
On the surface, yes. But in function. Ah, Commander. Excellent. We can begin. It is no secret that Advent soldiers possess both human and alien genetic characteristics. Preliminary analysis led me to believe that this was the result of direct modifications made to a pre-existing human host. Prisoners, or perhaps even unwitting volunteers.
See your local Advent recruiter today.
However, the reality is something else entirely. The Advent troopers at the facility we discovered, including the specimen before you, were manufactured. Each soldier possesses a unique genetic code. Predominantly human, of course, but with some fragments left open.
Left open for what?
Whatever alien DNA Advent wishes to insert. Sectoid. Mutant. Even the species our soldiers refer to as berserker. In all cases, human genetic material serves as a bonding agent, holding the strands together.
Human material? You mean the stuff we found at the Blacksite facility?
Precisely. The key component in their soldier manufacturing process.
So we've been fighting ourselves this entire time?
In a way. But I believe there's more to it than that. The human DNA in this specimen bears one key difference from the entirety of the sequences decoded in the Shadow Chamber. Psionic sensitivity. Given the sheer volume of strands involved, this cannot be accidental.
Screening process at the clinics. Avatar.
The potential power of a being created with this template is significant. Central. Had we not intercepted it before the process was completed...
I know, Doctor. Continue your research. Let us know if you find anything else.
Okay. So, we've got the framework for an extremely powerful avatar. The avatar we killed was a partially finished avatar. And unfortunately... We can no longer do any Shadow Chamber stuff until we get to the bottom of what is at that site. That site. Archon Autopsy. That would give me the cool swords. I'm actually going to switch to Andromeda.
As initially speculated by Shen, it does in fact appear that this creature is restricted to the confines of its own hulking environmental suit. Unfortunately for our troops, the suit itself is a powerful physical threat, regardless of the operator's status. As we learned with some astonishment in the field.
Yeah, they have built-in AI and can operate even when they're taken down.
Our efforts, Commander. We'll get to work on the new project right away.
Okay, and the rest of this stuff I don't really care about.
The Elders have always been elusive. Aside from the occasional monument, I don't imagine most of the people in the city centers have ever actually seen one in person. Knowing now that the Elders are apparently suffering at the hands of some terminal affliction explains their absence from the public eye. More importantly, what sort of ailment could possibly be beyond their vast curative abilities?
Just give the word and I'll get started, Commander.
So, we've actually purchased everything except Deadshot, Integrated Warfare, and Vengeance. We'll get Integrated Warfare probably, like, after the next supply drop. And I just want to scan until we get Soul Steel. There we go! There's no more training to be done. He is a fully leveled up PSYOP. So we are going to go ahead and stick Izzy Bailey in here. And she is going to become our next PSYOP. And in 5 days she'll have white hair. And who knows, maybe eventually she'll be brought on some missions. But now we can bask in Jagger in all his perfection. Full abilities. Every last one. That's a powerful PSYOP right there. I wouldn't want to fuck with that. Alright, so that is all we have time for today. I'm actually going to, like, give everybody, like, all of the A-Team guys their weapons back off-screen. But yeah, like I said, off-screen. So thanks for watching. This has been LCP vs. XCOM 2. I'll see you folks next time.